So, for those of you who don't know, we're morons. Now, on the right, we got Bill Ahrensberg, a.k.a. Alpha Omega Sin. Yay.
That's a pity applause, I can tell.
If y'all don't know who he is, just look him up on YouTube, but this is like your parental advisory. Don't have your kids around. Or around us either.
Any of us, actually.
Right here we got Johnny Millennium. To my left, y'all's right.
For the two people that didn't know who I am in this audience.
Ain't been Eric. And I'm Jay, and this is Stupid Billy.
Is this your water? For the record,
you can get with this, or you can get with that.
Eric!
Sorry your options are so limited.
Yeah, we're sorry, we're from Texas.
Yeah, your weather here
There's
is good.
A lot of sexy
How many of
people
you from
in
Portland?
Here today?
This feels so good here.
I just want to
lay in the street with no shirt on.
Yeah, I want to walk around with no pants on outside.
So what do you guys want to do? You want to do a Q&A?
Well, let's get into a couple things. One, none of us have any videos to show or premiere.
Right.
Literally, we're slackers. And let's just, Q&A. Y'all want to line up in the middle? Okay, I guess not. I guess we'll just tell mother jokes for the next 55 minutes.
Oh, we got it.
Just fine by me. Hey, there we go.
Nice hat.
Can we get this guy a mic, maybe? Is that possible? This guy's like, you dickhead, I don't want to work.
There's a lot of sexy people in here today.
So look, we'll just do a big ass Q&A here, and you can answer a question to one or all of us, or I mean any question that's asked, we'll all try to answer, I guess. And we'll talk about anything. It don't matter. Don't have to be
don't
video
matter.
Games. It can be movies, cartoons, your mother.
Relationship advice.
If y'all have any special requests, anything at all, just let us know, because we have no agenda.
So if you want us to take our shirts off.
Just like how you plan out y'all's show, there's no plan, right?
We go out, we don't know how it's going to go.
It's true, we don't. I'm just going to talk like this the rest of the day.
Professionalism, what's that?
Oh, Scott.
This is Scott. He looks like if John Cena and Terrence is chargeback forward, and NES Complex had a kid. Speaking
like
of NES Complex, he's over there.
Like low-budget Matt Damon.
There's a couple people in here.
There's a lot of YouTubers here right now. I like that.
If you have a YouTube channel, stand up real quick. Holy crap.
Hey now.
Woo! Yeah, that's your shout out.
Anyone here from Texas? One.
Where?
That's fucking awesome.
Which place?
Yeah, where? What part of Texas?
Dallas.
Hey now. Like Dallas, or somewhere? Okay.
Hey, stay off our games.
Are you from Oak Cliff?
You from Oak Cliff?
No, Frisco.
Oak Cliff's the hood. So is Pleasant Grove. Oh, that's all right. Just come sit on my lap and talk.
I love his voice, by the way.
So, in your video game nerd adventures, how do you feel that none of you got a camera?
Because I'm not important enough. So, I'm fine with that because the game's pretty fucking badass.
The fact that I got to download it for free was cool, though.
So, basically, the first question of the day is you guys are a bunch of worthless assholes, so.
Actually, how do you know we're not in? Maybe we're just such hidden characters, you just have to be good at the game.
That's so impossible to find. And he's like the third most important person.
Oh, no.
No.
Pat, more like.
One question.
Um, I think it's great that that got its funding. I think it's great for Mega Man fans all over the world. But honestly, I think Mega Man's overrated. I'm tired of hearing about it. So now that the Kickstarter's over, just please shut me up.
You're breaking Raw Man's heart right now. You know?
I know it, dude. I'm being honest. And I hate RPGs too, so y'all can throw tomatoes at me.
Tears.
Jay hates everything.
I hate animals.
He hates the laughter of children.
I want to beat babies with other babies.
I was going to say, and you would punch like baskets of kittens. Like, I don't care how much you pay.
Alright, so Johnny, I've been following you for a very long time since you first started on YouTube.
That's like 20 years ago, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. I've been following you for a long time, Game Chasers. Pretty graphically, you really like your guys' videos.
Thank you.
And Alpha Magazine, I just started following you because a good friend of mine showed me a clue of your rants and vlogs. So I just wanted to say, thank you for the years of entertainment and keep it up.
Thank you for watching. So appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks. So Game Chasers, what was it like working with Pro Jared? Was he kind of what you would expect, or was he a bit different when he was off camera?
I have nothing bad to say about Jared. Unlike Pat. Fuck Pat, but... Jared's awesome.
Jared's kind of sexy.
A little bit, isn't he? A little bit. I have nothing bad to say about him. He's just...
I wonder.
He's genuine on camera as he is off. He's just a really nice dude. Yeah, it's kind of bullshit.
I honestly was kind of pissed off how we came out, like bitches.
These two guys are the worst when it comes to spelling shit. So.
No. Hey, dyslexia is a real problem, and don't make me feel bad about it.
If y'all go back and like really watch Game Chasers, every single episode, something is spelled wrong. There's a typo in every single episode.
I bet you didn't know about the Atreyu 2600.
Yeah, he misspelled Atari.
Me, I was stupid enough to when I started getting out of gaming and was like, oh, that's just for kids and stuff. Like I went to GameStop and they were saying, oh, no, trade in your Super Nintendo. It's the last chance to do it. Had my original Super Nintendo in the box, minty, perfect. And I was like, I'm never going to play that again. I don't need it anymore. Decided to trade it into him. The guy was like, holy crap, it's in the box. Nobody ever trades it in the box. And I'm like, yeah. And I got a whopping $15 store credit.
So that meme is true. I did the same thing, but I traded for a Game Boy.
For me, it would. I wish I had like the stuff that I had as a child growing up, like all the retro systems now. And well, my PlayStation 3 broke. Eric, get your hand off my balls, please. When my PlayStation 3 broke, I thought I was gonna like go insane. That was about a year ago, so.
I'd have to go with what Jay said, because whenever I was younger, you know, I had like all the systems and stuff, and 1998 is when I officially started like collecting and keeping everything that I had, because I said, all right, I'm sick of fucking getting screwed over with all this trading credit, because they're like, oh, okay, you're bringing us an entire truckload of stuff, $50, that's it, and it's like, oh, thanks. Stop, it's so nice of you. But
I want to hear a rant.
That's the thing that sucks. It's like, I wish I had my original NES, my SNES, my Sega Genesis, my original PlayStation. I still got my original PS2. That's really about it. So, yeah, I just wish I had all that stuff. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, I sold half my collection for Sega CDX back in the day. I picked up Lunar, and that was about it. And so I traded, like, it must have been about 40 games plus. Yeah, I've been trying to get them back ever since. You know, you guys know what that's like, right? When you sell your collections when you're younger, you spend half your life trying to get it back.
Yeah,
the original. Yeah.
Like right now, all of our original systems are like probably in some weirdo's house right
now.
Yeah,
my original Super Nintendo could be out there being sold right now. I would know. Yeah.
Yeah.
might have it in his backpack.
Yeah.
No, we appreciate
nice
it.
Hat.
Alpha, I'm a huge fan of yours. It's great to meet you. You're one of the reasons I'm here at the Expo today. Cool. So, yeah. Take pictures. I don't watch some of your videos. I'm very sorry.
Not missing much.
I thought it would be with a hardship. When I was younger, I had an NFC2. We got it for Christmas. It was with my mom and my brother, so, and one day, it got stolen.
What?
The only game they did not take was Torok 2.
Damn.
So I was like, oh, well, that's nice. They took my system, but they left me Torok 2.
Bastards. Torok's not.
I think we were pretty much in agreement that with everyone else, it was bullshit.
You know? I thought that Microsoft was trying to get themselves out of the console game, honestly. There was no reason for all the shit that they announced that there was going to be with the Xbox One. But yeah, I hate Xbox like I hate RPGs, so I wouldn't have bought it anyways, regardless.
I know Melvor and I were sitting on the couch talking about it, and it was like, how could they think that any of this is a good idea? Like, are they just over there, like half brain cells is not even operating, coming up with this stuff? How did they think that the gamers were going to be like, oh, sure, yeah, I'd love to be able to play your game for a fee, or all this other stuff that they were trying to cram down people's throats?
I think they're just trolling.
Whatever. Were they trolling?
Yeah, they're just trolling.
They're like, hey, you
want to shake things up a bit.
But don't you think it's so embarrassing that you say all these things that you're going to do as a company, then you back off? Back away from what you said you were going to do. It's so embarrassing. Like, they should be really fucking embarrassed. That's exactly what happened.
And also, for you, what got you started doing what you did? What was your inspiration?
I'd say it's, I mean, I've been into gaming since I was 4, and I'm 29. And I mean, it's been like a really long time. And it's not one of those things like, oh yeah, I got into it, got out of it. No, I mean, like, I got all the magazines. I started going onto all the websites. I was like the person who, like, you know, my friends would be like, hey, what's coming out? And stuff like that. And I got sick of the fact that I was always watching and reading people that had bought off opinions that were full of shit that essentially I couldn't stand listening to, because I was just like, this dude doesn't know his asshole from a random hole in the ground on a fucking golf course. Yet he's getting paid a bunch of money to have said opinion, and that just blew my fucking mind. I was just like, I can't even handle this stuff. So, and the very first video where I said I was going to be on camera was the one GameStop video, and from there I was just like, you know, the hell with it. If people love me or hate me, I'm just going to keep doing it, and well, here I am with all these fucking knuckleheads, so it's pretty awesome.
Alpha, do you know your asshole?
It's honestly, I probably left it back at the hotel.
So thanks for answering my question. Alpha, it's great to meet you. You do what you're doing.
Thanks.
Thank you,
guys.
Thank you. Yeah, there's a mic now for y'all to put y'all's pretty mouths together.
Close. Close.
How y'all doing?
Good.
Excellent.
Oh, my camera's flying. Thanks for asking.
I don't have a hangover, so I'm doing great.
First of all, Eric, I challenge you to Street Fighter 2 later on.
Okay.
All right.
Let's do it.
And
no, there's no stakes.
There might be. There might be. There might be. I actually got a couple
I'm hungry.
Of
I
brought
can use
you with
steak.
Me, and if you can beat me, I'll eat you as one.
Okay. Keith's not. If Keith was here, I would lick his nipple. You're giving away spoilers. You're giving season 4 spoilers away, damn it. I lick Keith's nipple in Com Bravo. I don't know if y'all know that. For a game.
The sad thing is, that's not the gayest thing he's ever done.
It's not. I've been really gay. With Jay.
Sorry, we'll get back to the...
It's cool. All right, I had a question for everybody up here. I don't know about you guys. I'm a YouTuber, but I've also had, like, met other people when I first got on in about 2009. And I've met some really, really great people and everything else. And I don't know if you guys have ever done any trades over YouTube or anything like that, but I also, like, had some other friends that did some trades, and then the other people would be ripping them off and everything. And they would like completely disappear. And I've had other friends that would like disappear from YouTube just because they wouldn't, I guess, weren't getting as many views or subscribers. And I was wondering if you guys ever had anything like that. Like if you guys, you know, met some really cool people on YouTube and they just like randomly disappeared without even saying anything.
Yeah, I think YouTube though is a place where all of a sudden a lot of people show up and do video game shows and then suddenly next week they're gone. You know, type of thing. So I've had some friends over the years that were around in the beginning. If they're not now, I don't know what happened to them. You know? They just got sick of doing it, too many trolls. Trolls get a lot of people off YouTube. They really get to some people.
You can't let it affect you though. Stop crinkling. Jay just stole the whole entire audience.
But yeah,
fuck trolls.
Yeah, one of the things that really got me starting to do YouTube, I started watching other people do like pickup videos, which is like one of the most common things on YouTube that I've seen. But I also want to do YouTube for the simple fact that I could document all my pickups, and this way, you know, I can make sure that I have all the games that I need. Like a couple months ago, I also did like pickup videos and everything else, and I would also say like, all right, I need the second and third version of this game, like, you know, Sonic 1 or Sonic 2. And that's one of my most reasons why I do YouTube videos.
Nice.
And,
Scott?
More like not. Nods.
Am I right?
Shut up, Scott.
I knew it.
I knew I had that partition up for a reason.
This next question is for Alpha. I love your shit. Fucking awesome. And I love the fact that you love metal. That just makes it all the more better.
Metal is the most amazing music ever.
I don't know if you did a video or not on the Resident Evil movies.
No.
Oh, okay. Good. Just like you, I grew up with the original, from the very first Resident Evil. And basically, I was wondering if I can get your take on the movies. I understand that, like, you know, movies aren't always going to be the same as the game or whatever, but the most recent movie that came out, which was Retribution, I think?
I forget all this.
Yeah. They had Barry in that movie, but they killed him off, like, 30, 40 minutes later, and that seriously pissed me off, man. What's your take on the movies?
I'm a sinner, and I'm just like, oh, man. For a while, I thought about doing a rant video on the Resident Evil movies, because that's, like, a franchise I love to death. The live-action movies, if you look at them on their own, I guess they're not bad. If you're a fan of the series, it makes you want to beat your head into a fucking truck stop until you're dead, because they're inaccurate, they're hokey, the overdone CG, the Matrix fucking dodging shit, it's so retarded. But if you actually watch the CG movies, those are the ones that are awesome, like, hands down. Like, I'll tell anybody, what is it, Damnation, and I forgot what the other one's called off the top of my head. Regeneration? Degeneration, okay. So Damnation and Degeneration, those are awesome, but live action ones, they can suck my asshole dry. Which is, like I said, back in the hotel, so.
Can I say?
Yeah, I don't want anything left over.
Alright, that's about it. That's all I had to ask, and rock on.
Cool.
I'll be seeing you later.
All right, cool.
That sounds so dirty.
So when I was the tender age of 8, I watched Ghostbusters, and I thought that, oh, I wonder if there's an NES game for it.
There is.
So I typed Ghostbusters NES, and the first thing that comes up with is the angry video game nerd, Ghostbusters.
Okay.
And I watched it.
Uh-huh.
And he raped my ears.
He did what?
He raped my ears.
Yeah, he does that.
Yeah. Yeah. And he shaped my childhood into the mess it is now.
Does he know this?
I'm telling you so you can tell him.
I will text him as soon as we're done and let him know that.
You have his phone number?
I do.
They sexed.
Cannot.
He sexes with him.
Okay.
Sexy voice.
I like to send him dick pics.
Jay, do your sexy
voice.
We'll
put it on the bathroom wall.
Do your sexy voice.
Oh, yeah.
So pleasant to listen to.
Sorry, I'm a creeper.
Yes, and then I found Pat, and then Alpha, and then you guys, y'all were raping my ears.
That's what we do.
Jay rates a lot.
I've got to say, that sounds like a weird dream that some people might have in Rule 34.
It's you sound like you're getting a little around.
Yeah, you're opening yourself up to a whole slew of shenanigans shit right now, dude.
Hey, thank you. Joe.
Well, thank you.
Joe opened himself up.
Joe who, Eric?
Joe Mama.
Oh! I love mother jokes. I really do.
Anybody have any good mom jokes?
How's it going? What's your name?
My name's Jeff. I'm just wondering, any of you guys caught each other slipping yet?
Yeah. Wait, hey, spoiler alert. Spoiler alert.
This is a spoiler. This isn't an
episode. For the record, before he tells the story, I didn't get caught slipping yet.
Yeah, you did.
No, Jay did.
Hey, if you can get caught slipping in Retro Liberty videos, that you're not even in.
That I'm not even in, and they go flea marketing and
everybody goes slipping.
I have a store slipping in this the very establishment. I got a 10-10 Tetris for $12.
$12. And you got a double dragon on the Genesis.
Double dragon.
Complete box.
Box and
$8.
There's some good deals in here. I mean, just keep your eyes open.
Deals.
You
know?
More like bills.
Hey,
am I right?
Your jokes are coming out.
I think he's right. I think he's right. But I mean, come on. Who here hasn't caught anybody slipping? If you caught somebody slipping at one point or another, raise your hand. Yeah. See, it happens.
Did you guys see the copy of Little Samson?
No, I have my own. I don't go.
There's one here.
That would be a spoiler.
Thank you.
Thank you.
But this is directed towards the Game Chasers. Fuck you guys and your videos for keeping me up at night when my boyfriend's watching them in the middle of the night.
Is your boyfriend here?
Hey.
Good job.
Hey, that's just the way game chasing goes.
Hold on, here's the real question though. Here's the question though. What's he wearing when he's watching their videos?
Plaid pajama pants.
And is he touching himself while watching?
I'd rather be your guys' videos than Pat's.
Oh, dude. Come here and high five us.
High five. Hi, Dave.
We like Pat.
Emma God, Emma here.
More like Emma.
Is Pat even here right
He's
now?
He's here.
No, in here.
No, I mean in this room. Thanks for the support.
He's got
asshole.
Better things to do.
Yeah, I was gonna say he's too important. To
Someone should
out.
Go grab him.
Okay, so this is my question. It's like, now, Bill, you've done a video about cleaning used retro games when you were on Captain A-Bit on your YouTube channel, and wondering where do you usually learn that stuff? Like.
Trial and error, basically. Me personally, but you know, that video's actually kind of old, and I've learned some better tricks since then. Actually, Magic Eraser does a lot.
Oh,
what's that?
Make a part two.
Make a part two.
Yep.
I will, but you know something? Every time you do like a video like that, oh, this is how you do it. You get a bunch of people like, oh, well, actually, this is how I do it, and your way is stupid.
That or. This sucks. Why aren't you editing Game Chasers?
Yeah. When's the next episode of Game Chasers?
When's
Why are you doing this?
Episode coming out.
All right. Before I ask my question, I want to ask, how did you guys even get Eric in here? Like, how did he not slip all over the place?
dude, I knew it. I told you, Eric. I told you it was gonna happen.
I'm all right.
We claimed them in luggage.
Yeah, there's a Mexican section at the airport. We stand at the corner, like in front of Home Depot.
Or by 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
Every time I'm on my way to work.
There's a tamale like tree that's like right there, and it has tamales in it.
So for my question, I was gonna say, Alpha, I know you did a video last year when Taco Bell had that PS Vita. And now they're doing it with the PS4. I was going to ask, what do you guys think about that?
It depends. I mean, I don't give a shit who's giving away what, so long as they're actually giving this stuff away. Because if you tell people, hey, enter this competition right now, like if all of us got up here, like, we're having a competition, and there's like this vast array of prizes, and then you all enter, and we're like, no, we're just taking this shit home. We were just fucking with you. Later. You know, naturally, you're going to be pissed off. So as long as nobody's getting screwed out of it, I don't care. That's all good. Give away all the systems that you can.
Yay.
And that's it. That's my opinion.
Yeah. You said it best.
Yeah. All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Hey guys, love the game cages. I have not seen your two shows yet. I will get around to doing that later.
Watch his, they're awesome.
So, give you all a chance to foreshadow your Portland video or videos. Have you done any game chasing outside the convention, other shops in the area, or just in the convention?
No, the short answer is no, but basically, I mean, all the stores in town are going to be here, so all their good shit would be, like, in a box anyway, so we didn't really, no.
Okay.
Are there any marks around here worth going to?
There's, not so much flea markets, but lots of pawn shops around here that have, old video games and shit.
Do you have video games?
Yeah, what did you bring?
Who has games in their house that we can go raid right now?
Bro prices, though.
Bro prices.
I got Mario Duck Hunt, $500.
$500. Keep your hands off my games.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, guys. Thanks a lot for all the effort you put into the videos. It's a lot of fun for all of us. My question is for each one of you. If you could only have two systems and two games, what would they be?
NES, Mike Tyson's Punch Out, and PlayStation 1, Final Fantasy 7.
Overrated.
Top that, hot shot. I'm tired of Jay always walking around like he's someone. Like, Jay always walks around like his poop don't stink and that his wiener goes like this big.
I'm a pretty cocky conceited bastard.
It's even worse now that he's getting in shape and I'm getting fatter.
Yo, the Border Patrol agent, we're coming home from Toronto in July. He called him Fat Jesus. He goes, let me see your ID, Fat Jesus. That's a true story. Oh, but anyways, I would say NES, Mario 3, and PS2, Resident Evil 4.
Yeah.
Super Nintendo, Link to the Past. That's good. Yeah. And
more like Link to the Ass. Oh.
Is that what you and Eric did last night?
Hey, Billy, do you like to plant tulips?
Sure, I love it. It's a great, you know, hobby to have and good exercise.
Well, how's about you plant tulips on my schlong?
But I'm on. And this is going to surprise a few people. Well, I guess my PS3, Battlefield 3.
What?
Dude, I don't know why.
Really?
Yeah, 8-bit.
Wow. I did not see that coming.
No, that's what she said. I got through a curveball.
That's the damn.
Modern Warfare 3.
Okay, really, I didn't want to copy his answer with the NES and Super Mario 3, what it boils down to. It's a very generic answer.
It's really tough. We're sitting here actually talking about it. We can't figure it out. For classic, I got to say the NES and Zelda 1. They're so fantastic, but my ultimate game would be Street Fighter. I'd have to say maybe the Super Nintendo Street Fighter, because I could get some replay value out of that.
Which one?
Well, the first one, Street Fighter 2. But actually, you know, Hyper Fighting. Man, I could just keep on debating this one all day. All
right, here. I already know what I'm going to roll with. Systems I'm going to keep, the Super Nintendo and the PS1. On Super Nintendo, I'll keep Super Mario RPG and Super Mario World, because that's what the fuck I pick. And for PlayStation 1, I'm going to have Castlevania Symphony of Night.
Nice.
And yeah. Resident Evil 2.
Yeah. Thanks, guys.
I tried.
Johnny's, I like Johnny's hair.
First, it's not bad, eh?
This is what real hair looks like.
First, I want to say I love what you guys do. You're awesome. Second, my question is, I feel like everybody in the gaming community has like a game or a series that they think is awesome and it like means a lot to them, even though it's like they feel like it's completely underrated and nobody ever talks about it, even though they think it's like the best game ever. Do you guys have any games like that?
For sure I do. Like, the reason why I even came onto YouTube in the beginning was nobody was talking about like Phantasy Star 1 or Phantasy Star 2 or 3 or 4, any of them actually, and EaseBooks 1 and 2, all those great games. I'm like, man, like, why is nobody talking about these? So that's actually one of the reasons why I came on YouTube, because I thought I had to fill a niche because nobody was doing it. So that's my short answer for sure.
I don't care what anybody says. One of the greatest games on the NES of all time, Little Mermaid. It needs a remaster. They need to make Little Mermaid remastered.
I think there are... There's tons of games that are underrated and don't get the love they deserve. Tiger Heli on NES, that game is super fucking common, but it's a good game. Trog, I love Trog. It's kind of your dinosaur and your caveman. Eric, you're a fucking moron, dude.
So, Bill?
Wait. All right, I don't know. I mean, there's, like, I was just telling Johnny, I'm like, there's so many series I think about that people just don't talk about, and it always breaks my heart because they're really awesome. The Yakuza series on PlayStation 2 and PlayStation 3. Hands down, no shit. If none of you have played it and you like beat 'em ups, play them. And also because of the fact they have some of the best stories, like, ever. I mean, you think of, like, you know, you associate stories with role-playing games. This smokes them, and then some. Like, it's really fantastic, and I'll throw out the Shadow Hearts series for the fuck of it. Not the third one, though. The third one's rubbish. Don't play that one. Well, Shadow Hearts and also Kodelka on PlayStation 1, which is, like, the predecessor to it, so that's what I'm going to throw out there, because, yep, that's it.
What was the first one you said again?
The Yakuza series. There's Yakuza 1, Yakuza 2, both on PlayStation 2. We got screwed out of the HD versions, which were supposed to come here, unfortunately. But on PlayStation 3, there's Yakuza 3, Yakuza 4, and Yakuza Dead Souls. That one is kind of like a, we don't give a shit, we're just going to have all the characters run around in a zombie world and shoot the shit out of zombies, and it's really funny. I like a whole lot, because it has Majima in it, who's like one of my favorite characters. So, yeah, play them.
I just recently got into it on PS3, Yakuza 4. And it was really good.
I like that one because it's got like all the extra characters. You're not Cosma anymore. You got like multiple characters to choose, and it's really good.
I got a question about that then. Is it one storyline going through all of them?
Yeah, it's like I forgot to actually mention that. If you're gonna play them in order, because like I said, the storyline is really good, but it's a storyline, you know, it goes throughout the entire series. So, but the nice thing is if you picked up Yakuza 3, which ironically was the first one I played, it has a thing where you can see the storyline from every single one of them. It plays out like a movie. You can just chill back, watch them and shit, and that's kind of what I did, but then I went and I picked up the games because I was like, no, I actually want to like play them now. So play them in order if you are going to.
I also wanted to ask a question. Of all like the old school like retro games from like the NES, the SNES era, or even like Atari, which one of them that has never gotten a sequel would you like most like to see remastered in a new like PlayStation 4, Xbox One, 3D Ultra remastered sequel?
E.T.
Game of the Year.
You think they can do better the next time? Yes, I think it's.
I would say, well, mine's not a sequel. Mine would be a prequel. Like, I'm a big fan of Gremlins 2 on the NES. Oh, yeah. I think it's awesome.
I heard you, man.
And I would like for them to do, like, not an HD remake or anything like that, or a new game. I would like to do a prequel with the same 8-bit style, overhead gameplay, all of that, but based on the first movie. I think that would be awesome. Well, I love Gremlins. I'm kind of obsessed with it, so.
What do you think about the remake they're doing?
The remake?
Yes, that's his reaction.
Fuck CG! Use puppets, damn it.
Oh, man. That's a rough question. Like I'm trying to, like I'm racking my brain, man, because I'm like any game. Like, can I pick a Super Nintendo game?
Yeah.
All right. It got a sequel, but I don't consider it to exist because fuck its sequel. It's Zombies Ate My Neighbors on Super Nintendo. Yeah.
Dual Patrol is terrible. It's basically just a floatier version of its predecessor.
Dude, if you play them back to back, Gold Patrol is pretty garbage.
It's like the same game except worse. It's like it's not even a sequel.
Like it's weird because it's like I gave it a shot and I was like, what the fuck? Get this out of here! It's just like I tossed it to the side. But it's one of the, like best co-op games you'll play. I know it's on Sega Genesis too, but be honest, if the Super Nintendo version's way better, it sounds better, looks better, it just. You know, whatever. But yeah, that game needs like a remaster and a lot back out, so maybe Disney can jump on that since LucasArts isn't around anymore.
So, Bob, do you think you would bring it back as a 3D game or another like?
It'd be hand drawn 2D sprites. It'd play exactly the same, except for I probably allow online co-op and. I'd probably make like an additional third character for the fuck of it, and then like. I don't know. Add in like 20 extra stages in a boss rush mode. Screw it.
Screw it. Start the Kickstarter, Bill.
Dude, I seriously would, man. Except for, you know, people would just be like...
Kickstarter? More like Shitstarter.
That's what it would be.
You know what I would like for them to do? I would like for them to actually take like Castlevania 4 and make a new game with that same type of style. Too. You know, they do have Castlevania game stuff, but they're Metroidvania style. And I want them to do kind of like an old school Castlevania game, like off the Super Nintendo 16-bit. I think that would be great.
Oh, yeah. A sequel to Symphony of the Night would be unbelievable.
Oh my god, I've been dreaming of that.
Dream game.
Like, that game is. It's. I consider Symphony of the Night, like, one of the best games ever. If that got, like. I had talked about it on an old ass video, but I was saying if they got. Like, if any of you are familiar with Axis, who. Makes like the Guilty Gear and Blaze Blue games. If they took that graphic style and made a Castlevania game and made it like 10 times bigger, I'd blow a load that would destroy my house. My insurance company would hate me. All because of that game. It'd be amazing.
I want to see a new Battletoads game too.
Dude, teaming up with like Double Dragon Neon.
Yeah, Battle Dragon and Battletoads.
Yeah, Battle Dragon.
Another game you're looking for.
And Battle Dragon and Double Toads. I love that.
I'd have to disagree with the Battletoads one because they were bought by Microsoft, and everyone knows how that turns out.
Yeah. We try to pretend shit like that doesn't happen.
Yeah, we have
in a perfect world.
We don't talk about the dark times.
We still live in the 90s, okay?
Yeah.
I'd like to see another Onimusha. I like that series. That was fun.
I see another Paperboy.
Did y'all hear that? Sorry. I guess that's it. Yeah. No, maybe.
Well, I just want to say you guys and the people like you are what makes YouTube awesome and the whole gaming community. I would like to thank you for your time.
Well, thank you. Appreciate it.
So, do you guys have like a game that, you know, everyone thinks is pretty cool, but you just absolutely hate?
Shit, where do I start? Final Fantasy, Mega Man, Halo, Earthbound, RPG out there, overrated. Do something about it. Honestly, Castlevania's really not that fucking great.
Metroid!
No, Metroid's fine. Let's see here. I don't know.
I hate Halo.
I fucking hate Halo, dude. So, I guess so.
Call of Duty.
Yeah, I'll take that question.
Give me that one. So. And I know you guys don't really hang out with him, but is Pete Dorne dead?
Possibly. No, he's really busy with schooling right now. I talked to him a couple of weeks ago, and he's still doing the podcast, The Origin Gamers, but yeah, I haven't seen a video from him in a long time. I thought he was dead as well, so I didn't move on. He's probably buried under a pile of his own games. His last fell on
tonight.
Yeah,
he's
like under a bunch of
Sonic merch. He's just
like,
did
you see his hands sticking
up? Lies from your Sonic blush.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What's cracking?
I like your pants.
Thanks.
Those are my pants. How did you get my pants? They look good on you, though.
Mics don't pick up winks. Tried it. First question,
When can we look forward to another, this is for the Game Chasers, by the way, when can we look forward to another animated episode?
Yeah,
I want it.
Someone actually likes that.
Some love for
that. People just don't for some reason.
There's not going to be a Halloween one because it's too busy. Those things like, consume like a month and a half of my life. But hopefully there'll be a Christmas one.
Okay.
Hopefully.
Cool.
And we actually have like this really elaborate storyline.
Do y'all want to hear something?
With no, we're not gonna give anything away. But we basically were always thinking of ideas of going to the cartoons and writing the stuff down because well, we're idiots, we'll forget. But soon, hopefully.
And did you tell right?
Yeah. It's always fun to see all the cameos and the guest stars. That's cool that there's like a community that you guys can represent with like. Outside of actual game chasing.
I like that Johnny has like rockets underneath his feet in the cartoon.
Yeah, yeah. Like an alien ship in the last one too. Except two.
If you didn't notice like the last Halloween one, when the Frankenfuck, for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, but he gets shoved into the ship in like one of the cryo tubes. There's actually Johnny's in there.
I hope I get molested by the aliens in the next episode.
Awesome. You do. You do.
Graphic, make it as graphic as possible.
Can we look forward to anytime soon a Melvor and Dodongo spinoff?
Fuck Dodongo and fuck Melvor.
Okay. Sure.
I can say that because they're my brothers. They irritate the shit out of me. Like, they've been doing it since I was born. But, no, they're lazier than we are, so probably not.
Okay. Fantastic.
Probably still asleep. And it's like,
yeah, it's 3:10 in Texas right now, and I guarantee you they're still sleeping.
Right on. Last question. Are any of the hotel antics going to show up in a future episode?
No.
That's a good thing. Yeah,
okay.
It is. It's docking.
Yeah.
Cool. Right on. Thanks, guys.
It's too much docking going on.
Yeah. Link to the ass.
Thank you. Good question.
Like Zelda.
Eric.
Why?
Never mind, I'm gonna do it.
Hey guys. Hey, Game Chasers, I have you to thank for this fucking addiction, so just wanted to say that. Look at all this
that.
Shit.
Whoa.
Look at that. I'm a student, I don't have money for this. It's Uncle Sam. What's that?
Yeah, exactly. Hey, how many of y'all have lost a girlfriend or wife because of these two guys? Like, y'all's hot.
I hide it from her. She doesn't have any idea.
This guy over here, when there's
that. Quick question. Billy, did you ever find that Nintendo game drawer? We should talk later. I got something for you. That's all good. Jay, I had some for you too, but the Mega Man comment.
I'll take it.
I stand by my comment.
I'm sorry.
All right. Man of his.
Yeah, he'll give me a Dutch Rudder later, so it's fine.
All right, guys. Thanks.
Thank you. Look, I don't hate Mega Man. I just think it's a little fucking like overhyped. Mega Man 2 was good. I enjoyed Mega Man 2, but fuck DuckTales. I don't like DuckTales. I'm sorry.
All right, this question is for all of you. When it comes to making videos for YouTube and everything, do you guys work within deadlines that you let your fans know? And if you do, how do you manage to meet those deadlines without pissing off the fans?
Sometimes we don't. I mean, what some people don't realize that is that this isn't, you know, a full-time job, and sometimes life just gets in the way.
Right.
And some people understand, and others don't. Others say, oh, yo, you haven't put a video up in 2 weeks, unsubbed.
Yeah.
Thanks for the support. Mm-hmm. But, you know, there's nothing I can do about it, you know, but we do as much as we can.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I try to do a video every Sunday. I haven't got a video to put up more because I'm actually here, but I try to be consistent now just so my audience, they can know when I'm actually putting out a video, so I don't put up a video in the middle of the week and they're like, what the heck is that? I miss it, so. Try to be consistent that way, just for that purpose, and you put up like 3 videos a day.
Yeah, I don't really have a schedule. It's just kind of like, well, I feel like recording today, or I feel like shit, not recording today, and that's really it. It's random. My videos are lazy, though. It's just my face and like this. It's just like, I'm gonna do a video, and that's really about it. It doesn't take a lot of effort, just takes a little bit of energy, and yeah, so.
Eric, I like when you straighten your hair out for your videos, Alpha. Like when it's really long and it's long. It's a compliment. I'm not afraid to admit that I like Alpha's hair.
My flowing locks, like Fabio and shit, yeah. Except from like half his size.
I do the same thing as Alpha. I just throw crap out there. Nobody watches it. Yeah.
The trolls watch it though.
If you're a troll and you troll me, F you.
Dude, there's a Dos Equis guy.
There's a Dos Equis meme on him. If you go to Google Images and type in like Eric slipping or something. It's like the Dos Equis guy. He's like, I don't always get caught slipping, but when I do, it's not as bad as Eric the top one.
There's a lot of memes out there.
Who's trolled Eric?
Be honest. Well, of course, Scott did.
Who's back there?
That's cool.
Dude, right now, you know what this is? You just got an entire room of people, and you were just like, I'm going to lay out the welcome mat for them to fuck with me all day. Like, just come on in. Just take a shit on my brain.
I'm here, do it.
Hey guys, nice to meet you. I started collecting about 2 years ago, and you guys all helped me learn a lot about retro collecting, so thank you very much for that. My question is, if you guys could make a game, would it be 8-bit, 16-bit, whatever, and then like, what would it be called?
8-bit.
Oh, really?
RPG 16-bit,
for sure.
RPG 16-bit.
I was thinking that RPG 16. Oh, do you mean like a game based on what, though?
Whatever.
Just whatever?
Whatever, yeah. Like, say you're the game designer.
Actually, a beat-em-up would be awesome, too.
Do you have, like, any name ideas?
No. Yeah. Well, maybe a Game Changers game where they're beating up resellers, but that's
yeah.
Kind of...
I had an idea.
Let me just say this. Not all resellers are jerk-offs. I mean, there's a lot of other people out there. I know we sometimes dog resellers. What I'm saying is price gouging asshole resellers.
Yeah.
Those guys are the guys who punch in the face and gut balls.
Yeah. All at the same time.
Don't do what? No, I'm not. I'm not going to go off on that. I would just make a game with lots of boobs. So, yeah.
Yeah, boobs are awesome.
Like the guy game, but 8-bit.
No.
Well,
like,
no, because that would make it a shitty game.
Sega CD, that way it's real boobs.
Like, yeah, Sega CD.
Yeah, I like the Sega CD, Eric.
CD's nuts.
Yeah.
Oh!
I was like, all right, just get over with it. Did Alpha, did you have one?
I don't know, if I made a game, I mean, I mentioned Yakuza earlier, so it'd probably be a beat-em-up RPG hybrid, whatever the fuck, or like, sort of like River City Ransom, and I don't know what I'd call the game.
Shenmue.
We need Shenmue 3.
Yeah, we saying. Absolutely need Shenmue 3.
But yeah, because those are two genres I like a whole lot, and when they're put together, it's just like, best cake yeah. ever or some shit. I don't know why I use cake as an analogy, but I don't give a fuck. I want cake right now. Seriously, we need cake.
And Shimizu.
Yeah, and Shimizu.
So the reason I asked for a name for your game, I really just wanted to troll Eric and say that his game would be called Super Got Caught Slippin'.
Super Slippin'.
Super Slippin'.
Yeah, Super Slippin'. Slippin'. Right, so.
Get the hat that's Slippy from Star Fox. I'm Slippy from Star Fox. It's like Pitfall. It's like Pitfall.
Oh. Dude, Eric, at the end of the stage, they would have like the flagpole in Super Mario, and you can have like a really rare game at the top, and you know you can't always reach it, and then you just slip right down the floor.
That's a good idea, honestly.
Like, right now, if anybody can program and get all this shit together and just smash it together, and it doesn't even need to make sense, yeah. Just do it.
I want it on the Odyssey too.
Jesus.
Thank you guys.
Top loader exclusive.
Hey you guys, I don't mean to ruin any friendships, but Link to the Past or Ocarina of Time.
Ocarina.
Ocarina.
Link to the Past.
Ocarina.
Link to the Past.
Majora's Mask.
But we like Ocarina of Time.
Majora's Mask.
Majora's Mask is cool because it's different. But I mean, if somebody said, you know, you have to pick one, Link to the Past. Or just,
yeah.
And that one.
The two worlds.
And you,
it
three,
was just
and
awesome.
You three said.
I say Link to the Past because it's my favorite game of all time. I got a question. How many of you have played Parallel Worlds? It's the Link. It's the Link to the Past, like a hack or something.
Yeah, I saw that at a local store before I knew what it was.
Did
like
Time Walk Games do one of those? Time Walk Games.
Well, the White Wastelands, yeah, or Badlands. It was one of them. I don't know, but I've always wanted to try the Parallel Worlds just to see what it was like.
Also, I don't know if you guys did this on purpose, but you guys are doing the whole Mario and Luigi thing, though, with the red shirt and green shirt, and that's awesome.
Read the shirt.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw that. That was awesome. Okay, thank you guys.
Hey, what's up? Hello. First off, I bow to you guys, game gods. I love you guys. Love you. And second off, I wanted to ask you, like, what's the best way you guys have found to get rare and valuable video games?
eBay.
Honestly, you know, like, I'm somebody who uses eBay quite a bit, actually. That's how I get all my stuff.
I go to Backpage, and then,
never mind. Because you go into stores, and they, most times, don't have what you're looking for. Like, I've gone looking for, today, Panzer Dragoon Saga for a decent price, you know? It's gonna be, like, $250. Like, I know it's $300. Or, Snatcher, Sega CD, that's another one I want to get, but I haven't seen one in this show floor today. And there's like so many vendors, so my only option is eBay. And Craigslist, there's too many weird things that have happened on Craigslist. Some friends of mine, Play Lives over there, knows 100% about Craigslist. Yeah?
One of the best stories ever.
If you're just looking for like a quick, easy way to do it, then yeah, eBay is obviously fast. But me personally, for me, the best way is just go out there and walk the flea market. So.
Way too hot to do that crap.
But we do it anyway.
Alright, thank you.
Bye. Don't know if I'm overriding my allotment of one question per person or not, but I was thinking about what you guys said about how you think certain series are overrated. I personally think, and I'm probably going to get stoned to death by saying this, I'm not a big fan of Legend of Zelda.
Get the stone!
But I do really like the Game Boy Color one, Oracle of Ages and Oracle of Seasons. Those ones I really like.
Link's Awakening.
You didn't like A Link to the Past, eh? Not at all?
Somewhat.
What turned you off about it? What do you not like about
it? I kind of have the same beef with like the 3D Mario games. I just don't feel like I'm in complete control all the time. So like with Ocarina of Time.
What, the Link to the Past? No.
Well, I meant with like it's mostly with Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask and those other 3D Zeldas. I'm just not so hot on them because it feels so hard to control sometimes. You don't quite feel like you have that precision as you do with a 2D game.
Yeah.
So, I mean, just saying my thoughts, but just wanted to add.
Everybody's allowed to have their opinion for sure.
All right.
This question's for Billy. I pre-ordered your DVD, and what's the progress? Take your time, no pressure.
Yeah, I started like before the trip. No, is this thing on? Yeah. Okay, the progress is that they're getting done. Like it's seriously like a full-time job. And so getting these things, you know, mastered and stuff. Like I said in the videos a few times, you know, we could have just thrown crap together and then sent it out to people, in which case it would have been done. But, you know, we're all going that extra mile to make sure these are really awesome kick-ass sets. And so, they'll be finished here in the next few weeks.
All right, thank you.
Hi, so I just had a comment for Johnny. I grew up with the Sega Master System, and my first console RPG was Miracle Warriors.
Nice, I love that game.
So it was really refreshing to see your review of that series, and of course, Ease. And
I don't think anybody else has ever done Miracle Warriors, eh?
No. No, exactly. And I looked it up, and your video came up. And
yeah.
I thank all of you guys also. I watch all you guys all the time, and you helped me build up my collection. But I guess what I wanted to ask, for those of you who enjoy RPGs, what was your first console RPG? I mean, and Jay, you can answer too, of course. Yeah, okay, fair enough.
Mine that I can remember was Crystallis on the
That's
NES.
A good game. That's SNK.
Obviously for me, Phantasy Star was the big one. And then on to Dragon Warrior. And Dragon Warrior just wasn't as good. You know what I mean? I tried to pretend it was, but it wasn't. You know, that music, the battle music and Dragon Warrior 1 going over and over and over again. But yeah, that was a big one. Gubelius, I wouldn't call it an RPG, but I did do a little bit back then. What else was there? On the Master System, you remember. Miracle Warriors.
There was Phantasy Star, Gubelius.
King's Quest was out back
King's
then.
King's Quest. Ease.
Ease, yeah, was one or two. Those, yeah, legendary time. That was the beginning of it all. It really was.
Okay. I didn't play an RPG until Final Fantasy VII. I know a lot of people, that was kind of the same story. And then it kind of got clicked with me. So I was like, Final Fantasy VII, that's pretty cool. And then so I started trying a few others. I don't hate RPGs. It's not my favorite.
Did you go back and play any of the earlier ones? Did it inspire you to play?
Yeah, I went back like and got known play Chrono Trigger Man and all that other stuff on the 16-bit systems and stuff just to check them out. Yeah, they're pretty cool too.
Thanks, guys.
How you guys doing?
How you doing?
Well, I just want to let you know, I'm a big fan of all you guys, but I don't have a question but a request. Can I do a signature robot with you guys?
Fuck yeah, you can. Everybody, get up. Everyone get up and see the robots together. Stand up. I'm not playing. Stand the fuck up, y'all.
I don't think
I think this has become a thing.
I haven't seen inside Jay's pants yet.
3 minutes? Okay. Who said that?
Alright, we got
Yeah, we got
one more question.
I was wondering what you thought of what Nintendo did with YouTube and ads and taking the revenue away from people that put Nintendo content out there.
I think it was stupid.
It's fucking bullshit.
I mean, they're advertising their games.
Yeah.
I care.
Come on, Terry.
Do it, Alpha.
Live rant. This can't end without an Alpha rant.
Let's end this on the rant.
Live rant.
Live rant. Right. Do it. Do it right.
Howdy, folks. Okay. I had already talked about this in a video. Unless you hate me, then you probably haven't seen it. But anyway. Basically, I mean, Nintendo isn't the only company that actually did this. They're pretty much coming in and they're stepping on the little guys that are promoting their shit for free. Keep that in mind. It's free advertisement. If you have somebody that's like as big as PewDiePie playing one of your games, and the fucking dude didn't get the game for free, he went and paid for it and he's playing it, that's free advertisement to millions of people that you didn't have to pay for. Think about that for a sec, and then you're gonna go and shit on that person for doing it, thus pissing off that person who's a longtime fan, dedicated fan, you're gonna piss them off, and then piss off all the people that watch that. Essentially, all you're doing is fucking yourself into an infinite loop, into space, warp speed, never coming back, and that's a colon cleansing nobody needs to deal with, but it's gonna happen anyway, all because you had to go and say, oh, I don't want you actually playing my game for a lot of people to see. And their bullshit excuse will be, well, people can just see the game and they won't have to buy it. BS. Anytime that I've ever seen a Let's Play and I liked it, I bought it.
Yep.
Every single time. And I'm not alone. I can guarantee there's tons of people in this room right now. You've all been there. Guys up here, same exact thing. So, and they've realized when they did that, all they did was they basically kicked themselves in the ass for doing it. So hopefully they'll be smart enough not to do it in the future. And that goes for every other company. And if they do, well, you have fuckers like us that are going to take charge and put them in their place. So.
Really appreciate you guys coming out. Hope you enjoyed it.
Thanks so much, guys.
Yes, thank you.
Except Doug Rutter.